All right, welcome back to Titans Talk here on News Channel 5 Plus. Thanks for staying with us. Joining us now on the phone is our good friend, the radio play-by-play voice of your Tennessee Titans, our buddy Mike Keith. Mike, how are you tonight? Good evening.
I'm doing fine, John. Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely. Thanks for being on. Well, the day after is always tough for the players. We were talking to some of them today. What's it like for the play-by-play guy after a tough loss?
It's not as much fun as last Monday was, that's for sure. The questions were a lot easier, and there was a lot of excitement. But, you know, John, if you do it long enough, you kind of understand it's never as good as it seems or as bad as it seems. And if the Colts go on and hold this lead tonight, I believe the number of 1-1 teams that we will have tomorrow morning will be 21.
Wow.
So, you know, basically the whole league's 1-1. That's what you get down to. And I think, this team played very well in Kansas City, and many of the things they did well in that ball game, absolutely the opposite in this game. They just didn't do enough well. Dallas dominated the contest.
Yeah, they dominated the time of possession over 41 minutes, Mike. And it's something I've been harping on all day. I did it all last night on Sunday Sports Central. I talked about it in the first segment here tonight on Titans Talk. The rushing yards. This defense was not designed to give up 220 rushing yards, were they?
Absolutely not. And the way they held Jamaal Charles in check, you didn't think that would happen. But Dallas is good up front. DeMarco Murray's a really good back. The Titans are still getting used to the 3-4, and there were a lot of mistakes in the fits. That's what Coach Wisenhunt talked about today, and several of the players echoed it. They made a lot of assignment errors. I think not having Zach Brown is a factor. He's a guy who oftentimes makes big plays in there, replacing. But overall, I think when you look at what the Titans did and what they sat down and did in watching the tape today, I think they're very, very disappointed by their own performance.
Jason McCourty went out in this game with a groin injury. We still don't know what his status will be going forward. But it seemed once that happened, Mike, Tony Romo and Dez Bryant really, really got into a rhythm. And he was a little bit too much for Cody Sensabaugh and Bleedy Ray Wilson. Both are guys that I think have bright futures, but that's a tough matchup because Dez, you know, let's face it, he's a beast.
He is a beast, and that's a guy that the Titans felt like they had to match up McCourty with. He already had four catches for 41 yards on McCourty, but nothing too big. You know, he was really being held in check, and you felt like the Cowboys were sort of going to say, well, we'll go to him some, we'll try it, but we're not really going to push it. They fed him on their second-half touchdown drive when they went right down the field and were able to get the touchdown that really stopped the Titans' momentum right there in the third quarter. The two guys, I think you're right. I think the two guys did a pretty good job. Some of the coverage was really outstanding, but the third and 14 was the one that was really the killer. If you hold them to a field goal right there, I think even though it's still a two-score game, the game has a different feel to it at that point.
And that whole drive, Mike, was a drive of what-ifs. I mean, Bernard Pollard almost gets the pick six off the tip pass. Jason Witten bats it away at the last second. Then you get a defensive pass interference penalty on, I believe, Bleedy Ray. I guess by letter of the law, that was DPI, but I've seen a lot worse not get called. And then the third and long conversion. I mean, you talk about a drive of what-ifs. And, you know, a couple of breaks, and the Titans are right back in the game despite that drive.
That's it. And the Pollard play, I mean, he's going to score a touchdown right there, and the Titans take the lead. I think at that point, if you're the Cowboys, you're saying, here we go again. And the Titans go on and win the ball game. But Witten makes a good play to knock it away, and then Dallas just sort of picks back up. I think the key for the Cowboys, that run game, to take them into situations where they didn't have to throw.
Right.
Romo's clearly a different player right now. He's not moving the way that he was. And when very early in the game they were in situations where they had to throw, he couldn't get away. He took three sacks. And once they said, look, we're just not going to try to do this anymore, we're going to try to run it. And then, John, they were successful. That changed everything, because then when the Cowboys did try to throw, they didn't have nearly as much pressure on Romo. He was sacked only one time the rest of the day.
Talking with Mike Keith, play-by-play man for your Tennessee Titans here on Titans Talk. All right, obviously, you know this league as well as I do, better than I do, actually. Quarterbacks get too much credit when the team wins, too much blame when they lose. Jake Locker taking a lot of heat. Looked to be a little off yesterday. A couple of interceptions, some overthrown passes, underthrown passes. Was it what the Cowboys were doing to the Titans receivers, or was it Jake just being a little off yesterday?
I think it was some of Jake being off, but the receivers didn't have a good day. They didn't win. And Coach Wisenhunt making the point, while he wouldn't get specific, that he didn't feel like they were perfect in the course of this ball game with some of their cuts and some of the places they were supposed to be. But outside of Delanie Walker, I just don't think anybody in the pass game had a good day, and that obviously starts with the quarterback, Jake Locker. I will say this. Mm-hmm. I do think you have to give the guy credit for what he was able to do in the second half. He had a very poor first half and yet came back and played pretty well in the second. I was impressed that he was able to bounce back after such a rough start. So that, to me, is some progress, but let's face it, you just can't have that many halves like that if you're going to be successful. And that's something that the Titans have to get out of Locker, is consistent play like they'd seen through the preseason and in the opener at Kansas City.
You mentioned Zach Brown not being the lineup for the Titans defense. Xavier Gooden making his first NFL start on Sunday. What did you see from him? Anything stand out?
Nothing really stood out too much in terms of what he was able to do. You know, Gooden's about 230 pounds. Brown is more like 250. Brown's a big play guy. They wanted him to play more disciplined. They wanted him to play with more consistent effort, and he did it in the preseason, clearly beating Gooden out. And they were very excited about where he was, and then they lose him on, I believe it was the third play of the year, if I'm not mistaken.
Right.
So, I mean, I think Gooden is going to give them something. It's going to take him some time to get into that rhythm because he doesn't have much experience in this defense. And the Titans have lost a little something. You know, it's not the reason that the Cowboys rushed for 220 yards. Not saying that.
Right.
But it sure didn't help him not being out there.
You know, back to the offense for a second, Mike, if you don't mind.
Sure.
You know, I know it's running back by committee, and you hear Wisenhunt and you hear Jason Michael, the offensive coordinator, say it doesn't matter who's in there at running back. All three guys are going to play. All three guys are going to contribute. But I sure would like to see more of Dexter McCluster. How about you?
Well, I think Dexter McCluster gives you an excitement level that the Titans haven't had in quite some time in terms of that pass-catching ability. And he's really more like a wide receiver. You know, Chris Johnson had the explosion. Dexter doesn't have that kind of explosion, but what he does have is almost like a Darren Sproles-esque ability. Yep. To not only run it, but to catch it and make big things happen. I think he's more of a situational type of guy. I think you're going to see Sean Green a good bit. And, you know, we're talking about Bishop Sankey a lot in the preseason. So far in the regular season, we haven't discussed him very much. I believe he has a total of 8 carries.
Yeah.
In the 2 games, and I would have thought we would have seen Sankey even a little bit more. I wonder if going forward we will, or if they'll continue to divide things as evenly as they had. I'll tell you this, though, John. They got to run the ball more than 13 times.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think they can run it well. That's one of the things about falling behind and getting yourself in that hole to where you have to go away from it. It really kills you, because this is a team that, and with this offensive line, I believe they're going to be able to run the football well. So they need to keep these scores closer, get ahead, whatever, so that they can get close to 30 carries per game.
Yeah, Delanie Walker must have said it about 5 times yesterday in the postgame. We have to start fast. I want to look ahead to Sunday in Cincinnati. Tough ball game for the Titans. Bengals playing pretty good ball right now. They're 2-0. Obviously, their stud receiver, A.J. Green, a little banged up, but for now, you would have to expect that he plays. Andy Dalton can be a little bit erratic, but he seems to be off to a good start right now. What are your early thoughts on the game at Cincinnati this Sunday?
I don't know if you saw or mentioned the Chris Mortensen tweet from earlier tonight, but I'm just going to steal the information if you don't mind.
I don't mind at all.
Andy Dalton, in 63 dropbacks this year, has not only not been sacked, he hasn't been hit.
Wow.
No wonder he hasn't thrown a pick or lost a fumble. They haven't made any mistakes. You know, they're giving up about 50 penalty yards per game, which is not bad. No turnovers, no sacks. They're running the football with Giovanni Bernard. And then yesterday, they go to Big Jeremy Hill, and he gains over 70 yards and scores a touchdown. So you know what's coming. I mean, Cincinnati's going to say, well, if you couldn't stop Dallas's run game, here we come. Mm-hmm. And that takes so much pressure off Andy Dalton, who is kind of the ultimate game manager in the NFL. I know that he probably hates that terminology, but if you got the contract he just did, call me whatever you want, right?
Exactly. All right, we'll get you out of here on this. We've got Night of Champions coming this Sunday to Bridgestone Arena. Who you got, Brock Lesnar or John Cena? Does he get his belt back?
I gotta go with John Cena.
Yeah.
Gotta go with John Cena, no doubt about it. He's the guy.
He is definitely the guy. Mike Keith, we appreciate you jumping on. Look forward to your calls all season long on Titans Radio. We really appreciate you jumping on, pal.
Oh, glad to do it. I hope you'll holler back at me, especially after a win.
Absolutely, we will. We will. Mike Keith, the voice of the Tennessee Titans, joining us here on Titans Talk. We appreciate that. We're going to come back with more of your phone calls. Give us your thoughts on yesterday's loss to the Cowboys. If you want to look ahead to Sunday's game against the Cincinnati Bengals, that's on the table too. And we'll hear more from players and coaches as Titans Talk continues right here on News Channel 5+.